and the girl who loves the sea. It calls me.
Ngiyabingelela bonabonke abantwana bedlozi. Today let's talk about dreams, and let's talk about also monitoring spirits that affect you in your dreams, right? Let's just dwell on that today. And let me just say that before I say anything else. Stop asking for dream interpretation in kubona wonke umuntu ombonayo ukuthi uyi traditional healer or uyi medium or noma ngabe uyini. You need to stop doing that. Ukuthi you stop asking each and every healer for a dream interpretation, asking that healer to interpret dreams for you. I always see on social media people, when you post something, they asking about dreams, and yet I personally always tell people that do not ask for a dream interpretation on a public post. Rather, you ask me privately, because remember that a dream, it's a communication between wena na bantu bako, okay? And also know that it's not all gifted people who have a gift to interpret dreams, right? That is a unique gift on its own. So it's only a chosen few who do have the gift to interpret dreams. So just be careful of that. Always asking, because you need to be careful. Firstly, iphupho lakho lizochazwa ngendlela e wrong, right? And then they're going to convey the wrong message to you, and this, it's going to mislead you. And what's going to happen, lapho? It's going to ruin you, and it's going to destroy you. Because remember, because every instance, la ufika ubuze khona wena for a dream interpretation, and umuntu akutshele into errong ekungayona le kade sikwi communicate idlozi lakho. Angithi sometimes you take action based on what you've been told. Kanti usuthatha action on something that is not true. So you need to be very careful in always asking for dream interpretation, especially to people you don't even know. Rather, the person lo osukuse uyena ukhethelwe idlozi lakho ukuthi uyena muntu ozokulekelela, your mentor, ugovela wakho, noma ngabe ubani lo osebekulethele yena ukuthi akulekelele in your journey. Sebenzisa yena. Or else phahla ubuza abantu abadala ukuthi bakucacisele iphupho ukuthi lisho ukuthini. Yebo, ulutholile kodwa unokudideka ukuthi lisho ukuthini. But not ukuthi always you have to ask for a dream interpretation, because azokumislida, azokulethela ama information and wrong messages, and that's going to destroy you. Okay, so how do you see that you have dream monitoring spirits? You know, imimoya leyo esuke ithunyele kuwena ukuthi izobheka amaphupho akho ukuthi idlozi ni communicate lithini nawe, yini into abakhuluma nawe. Because remember, in our dreams, abantu abadala baye basivezele ngisho izipho abasuke besilethele zona, abasuke bekutshengisa even i-progress that is coming in your life. Bakutshengise nje nezinto ezinhle that is yet to come. Babuye bakutshengise futhi nendlela yokuthola lezo zinto. They communicate with us in many, many ways, right? Through our dreams. So lama monitoring spirits asuke fikele ukuthi azolalela, azobuka ukuthi idlozi lithini, bakutshengisani yiphi le mpumelelo abakulethela yona, so that they destroy that. Igcina ingasenzeki lento kade bekupha yona abantu abadala. Okay, so abantu abadala ke, what do they do when they see that you have ama monitoring spirits? This is what they do. They communicate with you through riddles. You see those dreams where you think it's senseless dreams, where you're dreaming of izinto that doesn't make sense, when you feel that it doesn't make sense. Well, it's actually a riddle that you need to pay attention to. Lezi zinto lezi esuke zenzeke in your dream, you need to pay careful attention ukuthi bakuvezela in. For instance, if you're looking at the picture that I've shown you, you may dream of white pigeons sitting in your home, maybe in your bedroom, your kitchen, and it's filthy and it's dirty. Right? When you wake up confused, okay, I dreamt of birds, I dreamt of pigeons sitting in the house, they were sitting in my bed, on my kitchen, or my yard, and I did not understand what it means. Uzuloku hambu yofuna my dream interpretations, and yonke lento le, you're trying to figure out ukuthi ithini. Kanti vele the message is for you to understand it. It's a riddle that you need to solve, because remember, they are monitoring spirits asuke sibona notice ukuthi akhona azogada impumelelo yakho, azo destroy whatever enhle esuke isiza kuwena. So they will communicate. Ubona ukuthi mhlambe I'm just making an example. The pigeons in your dream, it's representing idlozi lakho, and the filthy place la ehleli khona, they might be showing you ukuthi be careful. Idlozi lakho alizinzile kahle lihleli endaweni engcolile, okanye lingcolisiwe, okanye wena uqobo lwakho ungcolisiwe, okanye your home is dirty. So you need to take action. You need to take action in cleansing your home. You need to take action in cleansing those lack. You need to take actions in cleansing yourself. So they will communicate in things that lama monitoring spirits won't understand. What message is being conveyed to you? Get to understand what is it that they are showing you. You might see a lion. Maybe ihleli negundani with the mouse in your house. Yabon, that's a riddle. You need to try and solve what does it mean. You might see a cheetah, but if the face of a cheetah, it's a bird, right? You need to understand what is it they are telling you. They are never ever senseless dreams when it comes to a communication between when and idlozi lakho. Each and every dream esuke in a message. I'm not talking about just dreams, as we are normal human beings, we'll have normal dreams. But kukhona lamaphupho le, when you wake up, it will bother you. You'll be like, oh, what did it mean? I didn't understand. I dreamt of a bird that had a lion face. I didn't understand what it meant. And that bird was busy scratching me or biting me. I didn't understand. Yabon? The message, you need to understand the message. They're communicating to you through riddles. You need to solve the puzzle, because at the end of the day, it's not a meaningless dream. You need to understand that it is not a meaningless dream at all. Lama popo lao vuka konu confused. I don't understand. What did it mean? I dreamt of seeing a tiger, and this tiger was burning in Lilwen. Suddenly, when it came out like a rabbit. Those are all riddles. You need to understand. You need to learn. Maybe come out of your home. Ukuhamba uyophahlela ngaphandle, uhamba uyophahlela endaweni zemvelo, and just try and communicate with abantu abadala. Ngoba might be nalamba spirits, monitoring spirits, they're sitting in your home, they've been planted in your home. So sometimes it's best to pull muhambi yophahlela endaweni zemvelo, ukwazi ukuthi connect nidlozi, and you will get the answer to that dream, you'll get the answer to that riddle. So don't think ukuthi amaphupho sukuwaphupha, they are meaningless. They are never meaningless, especially, I repeat, lawa tuvuka khona ekuseni likubodharishe leli phupho. Ngisho sekuthulia, you keep on going on your day, but it's still coming back with, no man, what did that dream mean? It's a riddle. It's for you to solve and take action once you get to understand what it means. So bantwana bedlozi, pay careful attention to those dreams. Like uzophupha birds in your home, black birds, and in a filthy place. Maybe you're dreaming of your home, or just any random place, or maybe an old style home. You're seeing dirty kitchen or dirty beds or whatever, and then you're seeing black birds. They might be communicating with you that they are monitoring spirits in your home. You need to cleanse your spirit. You need to get rid of those spirits. You need to cleanse your home. You're born. So you need to pay careful attention. There are no meaningless dreams. And those dreams, they tell you the problem, and they also give you a solution to the problem as well. That's why those dreams, they confuse you, because kuba nezinto ezimbili or three or four things that are mixed at once. It's the problem, it's how you're going to go about solving it, and they are giving you a solution thereafter. And they are giving you kutike thereafter, once you have resolved that, how do you again prevent that from happening? So they are not meaningless. So that is why it's very important that from time to time, cleanse. Be a person who normalizes to cleanse yourself, right? Who normalizes to cleanse your space, your home, your rental apartment, noma ngabe kuphi, your yard. You must be a person who normalizes to cleanse your space. Because at the end of the day, if you're not a person who's dry as eye, ukuthi ahlale ehlambululukile wena yourself, or la uhlala khona izinto enjena ke ziyohlale zikubotherisha all the time, because awunayo into that protects you, awunayo into ezoprevent all of this from happening. Yabona? So ikubalekile ukuthi you cleanse. Kwesinye isikhathi idlozi liyayilikhulumele kwena. bebazi ukuthi akukho much that is bad in your life. Basuke bengafuni sometimes ukuthi uhambe for ama consultation. Sometimes they'll just tell you ukuthi go and cleanse, go and seek for cleansing, go and seek to cleanse your home, go and seek for something. Where else? Uzokwazi ukuthi uyisebenzise to cleanse your home. Maybe you don't need umelaphi ukuthi cleanse. It will depend on idlozi lakho. It will depend on the impact yale nto esuke siyenzekile kuwena emzimbeni wakho. It doesn't need an intervention of another person. Or basuke bebona ukuthi it's something you'll be able to do on your own. Or bazothi go and ask someone to assist you. Maybe that person does have impande. Ezokwazi ukuthi kulekelele in cleansing you. Ezokwazi ukuthi kulekelele in cleansing your home. And also to keep your space clean and cleansed. Yabon? So, ezinye izinto, you just have to be very careful. Entweni iningi. Dreams. I'm not talking about the ones that are just dreams, as we always have dreams. But kunalawa suke kubodharisha, where sometimes you feel like they are meaningless, they are useless, they are senseless, they are not. It's a riddle for you to solve.